Hey, I'm back for my second video today. I am doing this video. Like I said in my first video, I've been watching the Black Hebrew Israelites on YouTube, and I've been learning a lot. And so I just felt like everything that I've been learning, I feel like now it's my responsibility, now that I know the truth, to get it out there. So I'm hoping that by me doing this video, that maybe it will help to wake up some of the other Black Hebrew Israelites. I see them on the videos, I read their comments, and a lot of them are just like, the Bible's not talking about us, that can't be us. Like, they just, that's not us. And I want you to know that yes, it is talking about you. So first things first, let me give a little bit of background about myself. I was raised as a Jehovah's Witness up until I was about 18. Something just didn't feel right. I couldn't figure out exactly what it was, but something was off, and I thought maybe it was just me. I don't know if you're familiar with the Jehovah's Witnesses, but if you are not living the guidelines that they say you should be living, you're not accepted. And so I just felt like, well, I'm just a bad person. I can't live like that. And with my basically entire family, with the exception of a couple people, all being Jehovah's Witness, you know, I was taught this by my mother and my father, so I felt like I'm being lied to never even crossed my mind. I never thought that's what was going on. But now I realize, yeah, that is exactly what happened, and I'm also trying to get my family to realize the truth. The first thing I want to talk about is the appearance of the ancient Hebrew Israelites. I'm going to give you a few scriptures. It's not a lot, but to me, if you don't see it after reading these few scriptures, then you're probably never going to see it. The first thing, before you do this research, you need to push out of your mind everything that you've been taught, trained, religion that you've been taught, everything. Just push it all out and start with a clean slate. It took me about a year for my eyes to be opened, because even though I wasn't a Jehovah's Witness anymore, I still felt like that was the truth, and I was still defending it. And it wasn't until I pushed that out of my mind that my eyes truly got opened. The first thing I want to talk about is in Exodus chapter 4, verses 6 and 7, when God was speaking to Moses and he was going to use him to bring the children of Israel out of Egypt, where they were enslaved. He was giving him some signs to let him know that, hey, I will be with you, you know, I will help you with this. So he had told Moses in this particular chapter and verses, he said, stick your hand into your bosom. And when he pulled it out, it says that it was white as snow. Now, if you were to take somebody of my skin color and stick my hand in my bosom, pull it out, and it's still white, that's not really going to be anything miraculous. But now if you were to take a person of black skin and put their hand in their bosom, pull it out, and it's white, that would be pretty miraculous. Another example is of Miriam. In Numbers chapter 12 and verse 10, it says God turned her into a leper and she was white as snow. So if he turned her white, then she obviously had to be black to begin with. In Amos 9 and verse 7, God is speaking to the children of Israel, and he says, are you not as the Ethiopians unto me? Now, some versions are going to say Cushite, which if you don't look that up, it's not really going to mean much to you. But if you look up the word Cushite, it's going to say Ethiopian. Now, we all know Ethiopians are very, very dark-skinned people. And God was comparing his people, the children of Israel, to them. A couple of other scriptures are Lamentations 5 and verse 10 and Job 30:30. Those also refer to the skin color of the Israelites as being black. Now, I have to tell you this. If you have a new King James Version, it's going to take the word black out. You need to go into an older King James Version. and it will have the proper words in there. Now you have to ask yourself, first of all, why do we need a new version of the Bible? What was wrong with the old one? And second of all, why would they take the word black out? What are they trying to hide? Now, in Revelation chapter 1, verses 13 through 15, is a description of Christ. And it brings out that he had hair white like wool. Now, I want to show you a picture. I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody knows what wool looks like, but I just wanted you to get a good visual. Okay? Now, there's wool. Now, I'm going to show you another picture, and we all know who this is. But when you look at his hair, it is exactly like the sheep's wool. Now, I know it says that it was white, so I want to show you a picture of an older Hebrew Israelite. And when you look at his hair, that's exactly what it is, white like wool. Now, if you look at the gentleman next to him, who is a so-called white person, he does not have woolly hair. And white people in general don't. I mean, you look at my hair, it's not woolly. It's thin and fine and straight, which is pretty much the norm for the so-called white people. Now, also, in Daniel 7, chapter 7, verse 9, it talks about the Ancient of Days, which is God himself. And there's a description of him there, and it says he had hair white like wool. So when you read these scriptures, it really shows beyond a shadow of a doubt that God, Christ, and the ancient Hebrews were all black people with hair white like, or with hair like wool. Excuse me. Now, another thing I want to touch on is in Deuteronomy chapter 28. Now, the first 14 verses are talking about God is telling the Israelites, okay, if you keep my commands, this is what I'll do for you. The remaining verses are, he's telling them, if you don't keep my commands, then this is what will happen. I want to read chapter 28 and verse 68. It says, and the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I spake unto thee. Thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. Now, if you were to get a globe and you were to look at where the Hebrew Israelites were at, they would not need a ship to get to Egypt. So God was obviously talking about something else. He wasn't talking about the physical land of Egypt. If you look in Exodus 13:3, in Deuteronomy 20 and verse 2, it refers to Egypt as a house of bondage. Now, I want to show you something, and I know everybody has seen this. I saw it a million times, but never paid any attention and never really thought twice about it. But on the back of the dollar bill, there's a pyramid. Now, pyramids are notorious with Egypt. I mean, you say pyramid, that's automatically what you think of is Egypt. So why would the United States of America put a pyramid on the back of their dollar bill? Now, with the word Egypt meaning house of bondage, God was obviously telling the Israelites, hey, I'm going to put you back into slavery. Now, the only race of people that were brought over on ships and sold as bondmen and bondwomen, which are slaves, are the so-called African Americans. That's the term that the white man has given them. Now, like I said before, if after you do this research, which I don't expect you to take anything that I'm telling you, look it up for yourself, do the research. That's what I did. Anytime I was shown a scripture, shown something in a book, I'd look it up myself. And do the same thing. And if at the end of that you still can't see it, then I really don't know what else to say. But I want the black Hebrew Israelites, I'm trying to help to get them woke up and to see the rich heritage that they really have, and what a blessing to be one of God's chosen people. I mean, honestly, I'd give my left foot to be one of God's chosen people. So I'm just trying to help and get this out there, and I'm hoping that if one person listens to what I have to say and they see the truth, then great. I'm ecstatic. So I'm hoping that this helps, and I hope everybody enjoyed my video. Thank you.